comes.
I've written over a dozen studies on your species. I've published in several journals that...
Amusing. Asari have finally mastered writing.
What?
I'm sorry.
Never mind. What do you wish to know?
Huh. The Asari... Well, I'm asking the questions now. I thought it was Liara. The Asari were around in their time, I guess, were more primitive. So the Asari were around during the time of the Protheans. I at least cannot directly ask about what he just said. What can you tell me about Prothean civilization, though? How long have the Asari been around? I'm really curious about what he said. Obviously, they were a primitive race, the Asari, when the Protheans were around. I mean, maybe they were, stone weapons, etchings on cave walls, that kind of thing.
Liara here would never forgive me if I didn't ask you. What was Prothean civilization like?
Yes, I've always wondered. What sort of government did you have, and can you tell me about your religious beliefs, or perhaps the...
We are dead now. What does it matter?
I'm sorry. Studying your history has been a lifelong passion of mine.
When I was born, our empire was already at war with the Reapers. The first thing I remember was seeing my planet on fire.
But before that?
What was your civilization like before the Reaper attack?
We were the dominant race of our cycle. We ruled the galaxy.
My studies indicated you were the only race engaged in space travel at the time. I always found that curious.
We were one empire composed of many subjects. All eventually called themselves Prothean.
Oh, really?
What if they didn't want to?
They weren't given a choice.
You mean slavery?
Are you saying you enslaved the other species?
Any could oppose us if they wished, and if they had won, they would have ruled. Many tried, none succeeded.
I had no idea Protheans were so... severe.
It was by necessity. Very early we encountered the dangers posed by machine intelligence. They rebelled against us.
We've had the same problem. They're called Geth.
We could not allow the machines to surpass us. It was decided the only way to win was to unite all organic life within our empire.
Did it work?
For a time. The Metacon War.
Metacon War.
We were turning the tide.
Cool.
Until the Reapers arrived. Then we understood machines had surpassed us long ago, in ways we could never imagine.
The Metacon War. I want to read all about this. Tell us about the war with the Reapers. This segues right in.
What can you tell us about your own war with the Reapers?
Many of the details were lost. The conflict lasted for centuries. Those that faced the Reapers in the beginning were long dead when I was born. There were memory shards, however, passed down from soldier to soldier. They gave us fragments of what happened.
You know when I said it looked familiar? It looks like it looks like a pack of five gum. Only missing the top of the five. How did you fight Reapers?
How did your people wage war against the Reapers?
Attrition. We fought them system by system, planet by planet, city by city. Entire worlds were sacrificed just to slow the Reapers down. Time they spent harvesting a population was time we could regroup.
That must have cost you in the long run.
Yes. Our own people would be indoctrinated, converted, then turned against us.
Collectors.
But there was no choice. Mercy is not a weapon. It is a weakness.
Damn, so they're probably converting humans right now into something that we have yet to see. We met Vigil on Ilos.
Several years ago, we found a Prothean VI that called itself Vigil on the planet Ilos. He was the caretaker of a research project.
During my life, Ilos was only a rumor. It was said we had cities there, built on the ruins of a civilization before us, the Inusanon. If our scientists did have a research facility, whatever they were doing was secret.
Yes, Vigil said they wiped all traces of themselves from the records so the Reapers couldn't find them.
Right, so no
one would
know. The
scientists eventually went into cryogenic stasis.
More of my people survived?
No.
But they did stop the Reapers from taking control of the Citadel in this cycle. It delayed their invasion.
I never saw the Citadel. It was captured long before I was born.
So I noticed the... he resembles an insect in some ways. I mean, with the eyes, first of all, looked like insectoid. And the armor is kind of like a carapace, kind of like flaps, for lack of a better term. Not flaps, but like sheets of, you know, whatever material that is very like you'd find on like a beetle or something like that. So why did you lose?
Why do you think your own cycle lost the war?
What had been our strength, our empire, became a liability. All races conformed to one doctrine, one strategy. The Reapers exploited this. Once they found our weaknesses, we could not adapt. The subservient races became divided and confused. Then, it was only a matter of time.
I'm happy to say our cycle is different. Most races cooperate, but they still remain unique.
And it may be your only hope.
I hope he can join us. I hope he'll join us, like, as a squad member or something, or hang around and we can talk to him more throughout the you know, the story. That would be awesome. Your mission.
Back on Eden Prime, it looked like there were other stasis pods. What happened?
The Empire had fallen, and we knew our cycle was lost. We were the final vanguard. The best soldiers left alive.
So more of you were supposed to survive into this cycle?
Yes. Under my leadership, a new Prothean Empire would have arisen. We would have commanded the races of your time to prepare for the next Reaper invasion. But traitors within our ranks, indoctrinated agents, betrayed us.
Damn.
And the Reapers discovered our plan.
What would have happened if, your plan would have worked.
Just out of curiosity, how would you have commanded us?
By leaving you no other option. You would have joined our army, or faced the Reapers alone.
We've uncovered quite a few Prothean ruins. Were you observing our ancestors?
Yes, and sorry.
Before the war, we cultivated species who showed potential. Eventually, you would have been offered a choice to join the Empire. But when the Reapers attacked, we ceased all study. We hoped they would see you as too primitive to harvest.
Well, thank you, I think.
I guess they did. They did see us too primitive to harvest. And here I thought they harvested all organic life. Like, everything. So that's right, I forgot about that. There was a... not gonna see a scene. It's a text that we came across on a Prothean artifact. Wow. All these Prothean artifacts we came across, and now I have a face and a voice to connect to all these. It's so mysterious all this time. But we came across this artifact, and they had been observing early man. It was this whole story in text in the first game. And, yeah, pretty interesting. I'm not completely sure if I actually came across it or just read it. I know there was one... It required you to... Sorry, I'm babbling on. It required you to get some kind of item from the Asari consort. And you could use it on that item. But because of the way I did it, I helped the... I helped a diplomat with her, and that changed the way the other quest went for her, and we didn't get the option to get the artifact, something like that. And, yeah. But I did look it up afterwards, and, yeah, there was this whole story that kind of went on for quite a while. And, yeah, they were observing us. And then they had the relay on Mars so they could, you know, easily get to us. And that we could possibly use in the future, but... And again, we're in all the Reapers... All the relays were built by the Reapers, though, right? But there was a Prothean something found on Mars. I'm just, like, brainstorming with all this crap. Alright. Anyway... The Crucible.
Is there anything more you can tell us about the Crucible?
Only the stories we heard. They said our scientists were constructing a great machine that had the power to defeat the Reapers.
Right.
You never saw it?
By that point, the Empire was smashed into pieces. None of us knew what the others were doing.
Hmm. Well, if we don't finish it soon, the same will be true of us.
Yeah, he really doesn't know anything about it. Your sensory ability.
We've never seen a species with this sensory ability you have.
It was common among my people. Imparting experience through touch, the chemistry of life. Hmm. Complicated ideas could be absorbed in seconds.
That sounds very useful.
Hmm. We evolved as hunters. Reading 1,000 details in our environment ensured our survival.
Some kind of, like, biologically charged telepathy or something. Well, that explains the beacons.
Beginning to understand the beacons a bit more.
Later, we developed technology to harness our ability. Information could be stored in certain objects through touch.
Right.
Memory has its own biomarker, its own chemistry, as do knowledge and skills. The beacons could remember these things.
Things like Reaper invasions.
Yes, I can still sense the turmoil in you, witnessing the extinction of our empire. The fabric of your being was forever marked that day.
Right. Yes, a life-changing event, I'd say. And what about this room?
So, could you read something about this room?
I love his armor.
There was liquid, a form of incubation. The DNA of a Krogan who lived here. He was powerful, prone to violence.
I'm impressed.
Grunt.
His name was Grunt.
And if he were my enemy, I would have given him a wide berth. There is great strength in his genes.
You're impressed. Well, I'm happy to say he didn't die fighting the Rachni. I wonder if he knew about the Rachni. Or if he knows about the Rachni. The beacons. Yeah, we did that already. I guess that's it.
Thank you for talking with me. I never imagined actually meeting a Prothean.
Yeah, really?
This has been amusing.
Oh?
I'm glad.
To discover the most primitive races of my time now rule the galaxy. The Asari, the humans, the Turians.
We're not primitive anymore.
There's also the Salarians.
The lizard people evolved?
I believe they're amphibian.
They used to eat flies.
Oh, look at that look.
Commander, you may count on me. I am known as Javik.
And welcome aboard the Normandy, Javik.
Now you would wonder how he knows. You say Salarian, he knows. I guess slam unlocked. Oh, we got a particle rifle. Particle rifle one. Yeah, fascinating. Well, she just says Salarian, and he knows what that means, I guess, because he's... He has our memory, so he can search his memory for what Salarians means to me. Is there anything else I can talk to him about?
So much has been lost. So much has changed. And yet the Reapers are still here.
Yeah. The one constant in the galaxy, right?
For me, it was only yesterday. Our empire spanned the galaxy. Now we are only a myth.
Wow.
I still have much to learn about this cycle. I still have much to learn about this cycle.
Much to learn about this cycle. The map doesn't work. Huh. I'm on the Normandy, right? Yeah. Why isn't the map working? Well, let's check in on our engineers then.
Do you ever think about when we were abducted by...
No, I don't.
Me neither.
You should go see Adams, Commander.
Again?
Adams would like to speak to you.
You finished the thing?
Command, good news on the installation of that thermal pipe you got us.
I went right brilliant. Much better than we expected.
I told you it would.
It gets better. While interfacing through our Ezo capacitors, our Miss Daniels here had an epiphany.
Oh.
I wouldn't go that far.
She and Donnelly deduced some theoretical improvements to our capacitor design. Edie and I ran with it and documented our conclusions. Our core is too compact to apply our theories, but it could help the Crucible engineers. Give the word and I'll send the plans their way.
Do it.
Yeah.
Aye, aye.
Well done, everyone.
War asset acquired. Optimized Ezo capacitors.
Commander.
Look at your own little family going on in here. This is so, like, these guys are all so cute for some reason.
Those FBA couplings you got us are still holding up. Nothing to report.
Shepard.
Guys, you know there's a freaking Prothean in the bay down the hall? I mean, that's what I really want to talk about with you guys, with anyone, really. So weird, no... I don't remember who else is... Right, she's here.
You mean the biggest story in 50,000 years that I can in no way talk about?
I have seen him. Just wondering...
Commander.
That's so awesome, a Prothean. He is part of our crew? I wonder if the map will come back. Let's check the cabin, I guess. I don't know why, but... Map's back. Yoshis. Any emails and stuff? I'll just check it while I'm here, right? ANN Alert. New article on Eden Prime. From Alliance News Network Information Partners. Alliance officials confirm a local resistance movement has successfully pushed Cerberus forces off Eden Prime. Cerberus attacked Eden Prime for reasons that remain unclear and set up facilities to occupy the colony. But after constant attacks from a united populace, Cerberus troops retreated. Alliance officials are sending in evacuation reports now to get colonists off-world before Reaper forces reach the colony. We owe this victory to the Alliance, Resistance leader Edward Crabb said in a prepared statement. The people of Eden Prime have always been ready to fight, but Alliance intel gave us the tools we needed to push those Cerberus bastards off of our planet. Many Resistance fighters had said they plan to enlist to support the Alliance. Cool. Happen in tune. So if I go back to engineering, just curious. Map's back, okay, good. Javik, okay, yes, he's part of the crew, officially, you know. I mean, even if we can't bring him on missions, it's cool, we'll be able to go back and visit him and stuff, so. Hopefully we can bring him on missions, too. Shuttle bay. Cortez.
Shepard, thanks again for being there at the Refugee Memorial. I feel better. Everything's so much clearer now.
Glad I could help.
Not a problem at all.
I can't believe Cerberus would open fire on civilians like that. As twisted and insane as his logic might be, I thought the elusive man was trying to save humanity. I guess he's willing to sacrifice anyone to win.
Yeah, he thinks the ends justify the means, no matter how great the cost.
Doesn't hurt to go over the weapon roster one more time.
Ma'am. So let's check out this weapon we got. Ooh. Ooh, it's heavy, but has great capacity, fire rate, well, damage is like... Look, ugh. Accuracy. I'm using Mattox, sorry guys. God, the damage is horrible though. It looks like a really cool weapon. What about accuracy? I'm actually putting my finger on it. I wish I could get like numbers instead of like whatever we have here. Accuracy is much better with the Mattox. Damage is much better. And that's what's most important to me. Damage and accuracy. Everything else is secondary. So I don't think I'm gonna be using this, unfortunately. After the Reapers obliterated the Prothean, maybe we'll find a better particle rifle 2 or 3 or something that will be worth it. After the Reapers obliterated the Prothean Empire's warships, the Prothean resistance was forced to develop weapons that did not rely on intact supply lines. The Prothean particle rifle is a stripped-down, powerful assault rifle modified to fire without thermoclips or specialized ammunition. So I guess it's like no rounds. It doesn't run out of fire. That's a reason to have it. Alliance specialists agree that it appears to share some principles with the Collector's particle beam weapon, right? Although this gun requires a temporary cooldown period if it overheats. An amalgam of two different eras of technology, the particle rifle is still a deadly, efficient weapon. Unfortunately, at least for now, staying with Mattox. So. Anything new here? Well, we do have... This is the most credits we've had at one time, but... Widow rifle. It's a sniper rifle. At some point, we'll get one of these weapons. These are probably, like, freaking awesome. Yeah, maybe I'm saving up for one of those. Like too close to use it. Alright, so I do have the Cerberus armor. Alright. I don't suppose our friend James has anything new to say.
I still can't believe it. A real live Prothean. Doc must be over the moon.
He could say that.
I hear the guy's not all there. Exactly. Damn. I can't imagine. Brought forward 50,000 years, last of your kind. That's bound to screw with your mind.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, here's hoping he can help us with the Reapers.
True that.
I'll bet the elusive man's boiling in his brandy right about now. Took that Prothean right out from under it.
You're right.
Hey.
Hey. Alright, let's go. Why does a robotic dog need to sleep? I like how you can move up now like that. Anyway, engineer crew deck. Yeah, crew deck. It's move our way back up. Seven. So there's no one in six and seven. And Garrus went back to his battery. Dr. Chakwas is in crew quarters. I'll check on her. Sure, she'll have something to say.
Commander. Commander.
Or not. Okay. Nothing to say about the Prothean we have on board? Really? Idle chit-chat? Nothing? Bueller? Bueller? Alright. Where the hell is Mess Sergeant Gardner? Who's making all the food? Let's check up on Garrus.
Seen a lot of crazy things in my time on the Normandy, Shepard. A talking Reaper, a talking plant, and now a real live talking Prothean. Mm-hmm. Hell of a thing, waking up to find everything you know is destroyed. But I imagine the chance to get some payback is consolation. Doubt you and I will ever get a second chance against the Reapers.
Right.
What do you suppose the Prothean eats? What if it's boiled Asari with a side of fried Turian? I don't know about Liara, but I'm not taking that one for the team.
Shepard, you don't have anything to say about any of this?
If this war goes south, maybe we could freeze you for 50,000 years, Shepard. You could go from being merely famous to legendary.
I think I'll pass.
How's it going? How's it going?
Oh, just peachy. Alright, let's check in on Liara then. And our, Shadow Broker stuff.
Thank you for the data packet. The results are available on the Information Network Terminal.
You're welcome, if you're talking to me. I assume you are.
A Prothean. A living, breathing Prothean right below me.
He's not what I expected.
Me neither. He was a little cold when I tried to talk.
I noticed.
I understand the shock of waking up again. His species gone. But a Prothean, Shepard. There's so much he could tell us.
Well, the thing is, does he want to tell us?
Hello, Shepard.
There's that whole thing about free will and people having their own personalities. Not necessarily going to come in line with the way we want to be. Prothean Notes, 2186, Entry 1. The things this Prothean must have seen. If they had the technology to preserve someone for over 50,000 years, no wonder they were capable of building things like the device on Mars. I must give him time to get his bearings. But Goddess, when will we get another chance to learn so much about their civilization? Attached, Notes on Prothean. I want to read Attached. How do I go down? It looks like I can go down further from this, but apparently we can't. Intel from Battle of Arcturus. Telemetry captured from Arcturus Station shows just how quickly Reapers poured in from the relay and tore through Alliance fleets. VIs can analyze hostile fire in the area collected to increase weapon damage. They can also spend processing power looking for ways to improve shielding against Reaper weapons. Weapon damage bonus? Or shields? Okay. Capacity bonus? I don't know if I can choose both weapon damages. I don't know if they stack or not. This advanced amp is a sophisticated biofeedback system that interfaces with a set of armors microcomputers. The AMP can be set to help streamline the use of biotic skills and combat powers or increase their damage instead. Power damage bonus, 5%, or power recharge speed. How about damage? Cool. Upgrades. So this is just showing what we have now, okay. None. We purchased it? Didn't spend any money for it though. Well, that'll help slightly.